these vaccinated groups may be more likely to get COVID-19, study says. People who are fully vaccinated are the most protected against COVID-19. However, certain cases have found that the risk of infection remains. These are called breakthrough cases that happen because no vaccine is perfect. What people must hold on to is the ability of vaccines to prevent symptoms or hospitalization. If a person gets hospitalized due to COVID, things may turn for the worse. Breakthrough cases are small compared to the number of fully vaccinated people. Moreover, the risk isn't the same for everyone. Some appear to have a higher risk while others have a lower risk. Yet there is something in common in 3 out of 4 vaccinated people who develop severe COVID-19. So what is this common denominator? According to the US CDC, more than 159 million people had been fully vaccinated against the disease in the US as of July 12. Of that, CDC received reports of 5,492 patients with COVID-19 vaccine breakthrough infection. These reports were from 48 US territories and were classified as either hospitalization or death. But of the more than 5,400 reported cases, 75% of them, or 3 in 4 people, were older adults. This is the common denominator observed in the data. The agency noted that no vaccine could provide 100% protection against COVID-19, which explains the cases. Throughout the pandemic, people who died of COVID-19 were most likely to be older, and that continues to be true with breakthrough cases, a spokesperson for the Massachusetts Department of Public Health told NBC News. Usually, older adults have less potent immune systems compared to younger adults. As such, when elderly get sick, they are at risk of complications and hospitalization. The reality appears true in those who have been fully vaccinated. Besides the CDC data, a study published in Clinical Microbiology and Infection on July 6 showed a related finding. Of 152 patients included, 40% were immunocompromised and only 4% had no pre-existing health conditions. A total of 38 patients were observed with poor outcomes, while those who had no comorbidities, only 3 developed severe COVID-19 and had good outcomes after receiving medical intervention. With those details, people who may be vulnerable to COVID-19 should consider wearing masks even after full vaccination. Doing so may further increase protection against the deadly disease.